somewhat new, a friend of a friend that was in AA that I called, and I got some relief from this type of pain I was going through. Mm-hmm. And I think that these people that get some sobriety in here, they forget about our purpose of helping other alcoholics, and that there is a loving God and the consciousness of, you know, I think we lose sight that we're here in a, I think we lose our purpose of why we're here.
Yeah.
And Bill was getting his life back by helping other alcoholics.
Sure.
There's no reason for me to clean my life up if I'm not going to have a great sobriety. You know, it's like this is, yes, that's what I'm looking for, that this rest of my life, I want to clean up the mess I made one hell of a mess. But in return, I get my life back. Mm-hmm. I get some great sobriety. And I see people that have the sobriety that I like. They seem to be busy, 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 but they always seem to have time for you. Where if I'm not doing nothing at all, I don't have time for nobody. And so I just want to say that. You know, I'm not here about getting a brand new car out there and get a $1 million home and all that stuff. I'm here, you know, my spiritual, what I'm going to take when I die, and this is where I'm at right now. You know, it's like, I'm not really give a shit about a new Porsche right now. I really care about what's going to happen, you know, when I die. And I don't want to die drunk, but what can I take to the Lord when I go? You know, that's my higher power. What can I give Him? Mm-hmm. And the only way I can get that is by sharing my strength and hope with another alcoholic.
Thanks, Bob. Well, I've been rich and I've been poor, and I like rich a hell of a lot better. One of the... Yes?
On that particular story, what impressed me Bill was at one time going to go professional.
Yeah.
And he went to his group, and everything was quiet. I mean, it seemed like a great thing to do, what he was doing, counsel people, etc.
Right.
And someone, I guess, spoke up and said, Bill was wondering why it was so quiet. He thought that they were really backing him up, and he said, well, Bill, it's a good thing what you're doing, but it's not the best. And that's what impressed me.
That's good.
Sometimes things look like it's a good thing to do, but it is really the best.
Yeah.
I guess it's a matter of, I always get the word, early Alzheimer's. Finding out through God's help the right thing to do, inspiration.
Well, that happened to have been a very important revelation, because we found out in latter days that people who are here in recovery but who take on a job and with treatment centers and so forth have a real, real tough time staying sober. And apparently it's because while they're in their workaday, they're required to adopt the agenda of the treatment center, which almost always has human solutions involved rather than spiritual solutions. And also, when we carry a message, we can have no agenda. We must leave the results up to God. It isn't up to us whether somebody gets sober or not. It is up to us to carry the message. And so, historically, it's been very difficult for people to stay sober and to also spend most of their working day carrying the message of psychiatry or psychology or the human solutions and following somebody else's agenda and having to account for their successes in the recovery process. So it's a difficult thing, and people who do it successfully have to split these two things completely apart, their work your 12-step work on the one hand, which is without any agenda at all, and their work for which you're getting paid, where they're required to do certain things in order to be paid to do it. So I think that was a significant insight, even at that time, that this probably wouldn't work very well. Did you want to share with us tonight?
I'm just new to the program, and I just come in here to listen.
Yeah, what's your name?
Bob.
Hey, Bob.
Hey, hello, Bob.
Well, we're glad to have you here with us. You got any questions we can help you with?
Well, I've been coming to the 1-on-1, the 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock meetings for the last 3 months or so.
Mm-hmm.
I went to some of the other meetings around, and I like this club the best as far as...
Well, good.
Because there's no rules, I mean, just stick to the traditions, which I know not much about. But anyway, I feel welcome.
Well, that's good, Bobby. You sure are welcome, you know. And you might want to try to get to know a few people around here. You'll find it.
I've got to go to court 3rd. So I'm not going to be around here for a while, but not for my choice.
They're going to incarcerate you for a while, you think?
I think so.
Yeah. You might be surprised when you go in there, and if you're actually sober and you've been working the program, you may be surprised at what happens.
I'm getting a bunch of meetings under my belt.
Well, you might want to get a few people to write letters for you and stuff, you know, and just because the judges really like to see that you're trying to get sober and stay sober. It's real important. All right, guys, we have anything else? Is there any irresistible impulse? Tommy? No? Okay, let's close the meeting. That's it.
Stay close.
All right, let's let this circle represent the unity of our fellowship. Our moment of silence for those who are still suffering. And we'll say the Lord's Prayer together. And please remember the stairway to the food saying and not to say amen. Thank you. Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you all for being here.
Thank you.
We'll see you back next week. God willing, the Christ will rise.
Same time, same channel. Yeah.